You are saying?
No, I'm saying that outdoor is not a dangerous place, it's a better place, but in a city, outdoor means they go sit in a restaurant or they get into your bus or they crowd themselves somewhere, so it is dangerous. But if you're living in small towns or in rural areas, it is better to be outdoors than many people being in one room.
You know, Sadguru, yesterday, PM's request to clap at 5 p.m., you know, people were connecting it with, you know, sound vibrations to kill corona or negative vibrations. So, how true is that?
Well, why can't we simply acknowledge a few people who strive to keep us healthy, well and safe? Why can't we simply acknowledge out of our open heart? We have to find some celestial reasons, some mystical reasons for all this. Well, this is the reason why mysticism has become a joke for a lot of people, simply because people try to find mystical reasons for every simple thing that happens. Well, every moment of our life, we are in a celestial space. We are living on a planet which is a solar system, which is a part of a galaxy or whatever, whatever. So if somebody is looking at you from somewhere else, definitely we are celestial. So something always is influencing everything, so that's not the point. Why don't we be straight enough to simply acknowledge people who serve us?
But is there a connection also?
See, you won't give it up. You won't give it up. No, there is a beauty to simply bow down and say thank you to somebody for their service to us, rather than finding all kinds of reasons for it.
Yes, Sadguru. Sadguru, should the world have handled this situation differently so that it wouldn't have reached this point?
See, we can always say this. We can always go about commenting. Those who don't do anything, those who don't have to manage anything in their lives, those who openly claim they live on Twitter or social media or something, they live there, I believe. So they don't have a life of their own. Such people can go on commenting. Ask them to manage something, ask them to take one extension of a city and manage it properly. They won't be able to do it. So the world is such a nebulous place and people are moving, today everybody is traveling. It is not like how it was 1,000 years ago where, you know, you could have stopped travel. If you just blocked one road, nobody would go anywhere. So it is not like that. People travel in so many ways and they have traveled all over. Where all they have gone, nobody knows. People say from Wuhan itself, 5 million people moved out. To what all places they have gone, who all they have infected, how many people they have infected, is it even measurable, is it even possible to do that? Because you are dealing with an invisible adversary. It's not visible. It's not like locusts or mosquitoes or mice or anything. This is invisible and it can just go from anywhere to anywhere. So it's easy to comment, this is a time to support. This is a time to support whatever agencies we have. Are they perfect? Definitely not. I don't think any agency in any country in the world is a perfect agency, either medical or otherwise. There is no such perfect agencies. Well, we have the kind of agencies we have for the country that we are, for the economic, you know, capabilities that we have, accordingly we have. The thing is to make the best out of it. Instead of doing responsible action, we are always busy commenting about somebody, this could have been done better, I would have done this better. No, if that is not the way it is. It's a complex situation. There is no profit in simply giving commentaries on this. How to deal with it now? What can I do about it? What can you do about it? This is all that's important. Instead of going on criticizing somebody, it could have been done better.
Sadhguruji, what are the precautions that the world needs to take so that such disasters doesn't happen again?
Oh, there is no such precaution.
That's bad news.
No, it happens once in a way. This happens that we need to understand there is life. There is life all around us and within us. Actually, there are more bacteria and virus in our body than our own cells in terms of numbers. So, without them we cannot live. The very atmosphere we live in, the soil that we walk upon, the food that we eat is all full of bacteria and virus. A few of them, well, take a toll on us, rest of them work with our systems. So even this virus, if you give it enough time, it will kind of mutate itself to become benign in our experience. But right now it is in a virulent state that it can affect our lives. So is there some magic solution that no virus will come in the future? There is no such magic solution. So you can… somebody may make a business out of magic solutions, but there are no magic solutions.
Sadhguru, a lot of people are going to get hit because of the lockdown and all, especially ones who work on daily wages. Should government take some steps to help them? Also, even people who are paying their EMIs through their businesses have got hit. So, you know, I've heard that in few countries they have pushed the EMIs. Should our government also do something about it, that people can pay EMIs later or something?
I think that thought process is on how to support the daily wage earners. Fortunately, we built a certain amount of financial infrastructure in terms of crores of people having bank accounts. Of course, a whole lot of people made commentary, what is the use of a bank account without money? Well, this is the use. Right now, without asking them to come somewhere and stand in a queue, you can send money to their bank account, which is a significant step. So, these things are in the works, but to what extent we can do this is always a question mark, because the strain on the country's economy is going to be so big. How much can government do is also a big question mark. They will try to do their best, but the best will not serve still everybody. There will be still a lot of suffering for individual human beings. So, those people who are moving into starvation mode because of lack of daily earnings, I think just expecting the government to do it is not it. In our communities, wherever we live, in our localities, we must look out and see if there are such people. Communities should come together and ensure at least basic nourishment is taken care of, if not anything else. At least to pass through this basic nourishment, it is our responsibility wherever we are, institutions, families, industry, whoever you are, businesses, whoever you are, I think some basic nourishment, if it's moving into a starvation mode, that may not happen right now, but if this continues, it could happen in the next 15, 2 to 4 weeks' time. When that begins to happen, the citizens have to step up their responsibility and act.
Sadhguru, two more questions. One is, there are two type of people. One are who are not taking it that seriously. One is who are getting into panic, you know, slowly. So this panic, you know, type of people are also becoming problems for few people who have asked me to ask you this question, how to handle that panic.
And being uncaring and being panicky, both are hugely damaging for the situation that we are in. What is needed is resolute action in terms of that you're not the carrier, that you must take care of. That you don't get infected and you don't infect anybody. This responsibility each person has to take. Being fearful and panicky is not going to help, because we will… panic spreads faster than virus. Fear and panic can spread much faster than virus, so that can cause huge damage to us. And, oh, nothing will happen to me, this is just silly. Because it's not just about your health. So many people's lives will be put to risk, but particularly vulnerable segments of our society in terms of age and other aspects, they will be put to serious risk. It's very, very important everybody behaves responsibly. Responsibly means that you respond to the situation in a judicious way. If you react, you will become panicky. There's no need to react to this. We must act responsibly. What are the preconditions? Everybody knows this, how it works right now. The thing is, it moves only from human being to human being. So the important thing is to create a distance. Now, if I create a distance, I will go mentally crazy. Well, when people were close to you, you were complaining about them. When you had to work every day, you were complaining about that. Every day you have to do all the tasks that you do, you were complaining. Now there is nothing to do, at least at this time, spend a little bit of time peacefully, joyfully. If you do not know how, there are tools available. Well, we are providing various tools. The simple thing is, there is a chant and a Isha Kriya, a package of that we will release it probably today or tomorrow. This is a simple way, 3 to 5 times a day if you do this, it will keep you mentally good. This is a time for you to sit back and at least enjoy your life, read a book, go for a, you know, go just jog on the spot. If you don't know any yoga, if you know something, you do it. Otherwise, at least, you know, spend some time with yourself and your family. This is a way to do it, because don't call it lockdown, don't call it curfew. This is your time. Virus has given you a break. Take a break and let's do it, because when this passes, all of us who live through this will have lot of work to do after the virus is gone to put things back in place.
Suddenly, corona is sounding nice now after you've explained so much.
No, don't think Sadguru, it's nice, it's not nice. See, what life throws at us is not our choice. It throws all kinds of things. What we make out of it is our choice. This choice you must exercise.
So, Sadguruji, is it possible for a person like you to foresee such things in advance, or someone who does, you know, yoga to foresee such things?
Now you're trying to get me into trouble that I was the source of this virus or something. Huh? Sadguru knew beforehand this virus will come. That means he was the source of the virus.
People asked me to ask you, then I said, even Krishna could have stopped Mahabharata, he didn't.
Don't go that far back, huh? You don't know what happened at that time exactly.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Sadguru. What you are doing is great. We bow down to you also.